Yellow Productions presents
a video review of the Osaka Marriott Miyako Hotel in Osaka, Japan. I'm Chris, this is Topher, this is Yellow Productions. We do travel guides that are fun, informative, and entertaining. This is part of our series on Japan. And in this video, we're going to be telling you everything you need to know if you're considering staying at this hotel in Osaka, including the neighborhood around the hotel, the common areas of the hotel, and the inside of one of the rooms. The Osaka Marriott Miyako Hotel is located in the new Abeno Harukas Tower. It occupies the 38th to the 57th floor. Check-in is on the 19th floor. It's really conveniently located right above the Tennoji subway station. There's the subway there, there's the JR line, there's four different lines that come into it, and the whole neighborhood has a whole shopping complex super close to lots of shops and convenience stores as well. It's not right in the center of the city, but this is almost becoming the third downtown of Osaka. If you're arriving from the airport, you'll likely take the JR Haruka train into the JR station. The building is right across the street. If you're coming in from the subway, then you'll come in from the basement one level elevators. It was pretty easy to find. When you're in the stations, just look for the exits that say Abeno Harukas. Go that way. There's a special elevator that'll take you up to the 19th floor, which is the lobby of the Marriott. When you get to the 19th floor, it is actually a pretty big, almost like two-story floor. The lobby has a bar, a lounge, a restaurant, the concierge, the check-in area. There's a lot of things in the lobby. The staff was very fast, efficient, friendly. They came, took my luggage. I was checked in quick and took me up to the room. Up on the 38th floor, you'll find the club lounge, which is open from 6 a.m. to midnight. They do breakfast, afternoon tea time, cocktail time, bar time. I'll talk more about the lounge in the review section of this video. Also on the 38th floor is the gym, which is a good medium-sized gym. Great views of Osaka from the windows. But the most interesting thing were the waivers you had to sign. I've never seen something like that before. You have to sign a waiver, drop it in a box before you go and use the gym. And then the business center, it's got a copy machine, things like that, and that's open for guests. There's also a restaurant all the way on the 57th floor. I did not dine there because it looks fairly expensive.
And true to Marriott form, every floor has an ice machine on it. A little Hoshizaki. The elevator lobbies are bright spaces because they've got glass windows that look out on Osaka, so you can admire the view while you're waiting for the elevator, too. I love this. Now that we've seen everything around the hotel, let's check out one of the rooms.
This is room 5109, a king bedroom on the 51st floor. Come on in, let me show you around. As you come inside the room, the first thing you'll see back here is a big king-size bed, nice white sheets. Topher, he's already fallen over and gone to sleep. I need to pick him up there. Topher, we have a video to do. In front of that bed, there is a yellow chaise sofa that you can lounge on that has a little chair in front of it. Couple headboards there in the back, clock over on the right. But if we turn this way, one of the real distinctive features about this room, it's on the 51st floor, so there's an amazing view of Osaka out there. I'll show you more of what that looks like in the day, but as I checked in, they said you could see Osaka Castle and a whole bunch of amazing things that way. The desk in the room is right here in the corner. It's a big round table that looks out on the window, which I think is pretty nice. There is a air purifier in the room, which is common in a lot of Japanese hotels. Not common in a lot of Marriotts, though. Over here, just underneath the desk, there are the power ports that are in the room right here. And then there's the mini bar right here. I'll point out that when I checked in, these things were both covered and they're hidden. And so to find them, actually the guy who showed me the room, the bellboy, he opened these up to point out these things were hidden. This is a room of hidden things. Actually, the television remote that's right here, it hides in this little house. I was looking for that remote for like 5 minutes before I found it. There's a couple complimentary bottles of water. There's an espresso coffee machine. There's a teapot for making hot water. Up here, there is the tea ice bucket glasses. I'll point out that this cabinet is actually illuminated, and it lights up when you open it. There is the flat panel television in the room, and underneath it there's the safety box and those sorts of things over there. Now, I'm going to turn this way and show you the bathroom. You see, the bathroom is actually connected to the main part of the room. You can actually see into it right there. That's the back of the mirror. And then there's this wall right here, or what looks like a wall. But if we come over this way, this wall in the room actually slides that way to reveal the bathtub right there. So I'm gonna go handheld to show you the bathroom. I think it'll work better that way. So this is the bathroom with that wall slid over. So this way the mirror has the wall behind it before you could look through here into the room. This is the sink. There's a lot of Marriott amenities. Actually, the sink I think has the most Marriott amenities I've seen in every room. The standard hair conditioner, shampoo, body wash, all that stuff. But then over here, they've also got the mouthwash and shaving gel. And this is branded with the Marriott Osaka Miyako particular shaving gel, so not just a standard Marriott amenity. Also, typical for many Japanese hotels, so I like to see it in this Marriott, is a whole kit of everything you would ever need if you're here. Toothbrush, vanity kit, razor, ladies kit, and two hairbrushes. Kleenex box, little towels back here. Those are interesting. I'm not sure what to do with those. The hand towels have an M emblazoned in them. That's pretty nice. And then there's the shower and bath part of the room. Japanese are really big into bathing, so this is a big part of the room. It's a big enclosed area. It has a door on it that can close the whole thing off. It has a little stool so you can sit when you're taking a shower. It's a nice handheld unit. And then down here, it's a big soaking tub. This tub would fit me. And then because I slid that wall out of the way from the tub, you can see into the room and you can see the nighttime view of Osaka. All right, and then here, there's a thing that actually has like a bath spout timer. So you can set this bath spout to just run for like 5-10 minutes. That way you don't end up overflowing the room. Fill it up for 10 minutes and it fills up your tub. Let's check out the final part of the bathroom. It's the part that has the toilet. It's one of these really fancy Toto toilets. The lids close. How do you open a toilet lid? Well, of course, you push a button over here on the control panel to open the lid. You want to lift up the seat? How do you do that? You push another button to lift up the seat. This is super fancy controls. It even tells you the time on it. It has a bidet. You can wash your behind. You can have it oscillate. And then when you're done and you want to flush the toilet, there's two different flushes, a little flush and a big flush. So we're going to give that a big flush. And there we go. The toilet flushes just for us. The final part of the room, there's the door that we came in through. Why is that interesting? Well, because the do not disturb and the make up the room, they're just buttons. You flip on the sides here. And then there's a nice big mirror by the door, floor to ceiling. And then there's the closet in the room, which is illuminated. You'll see as I turned on that light. That's got my jacket that's in there, some robes. And then down here, it's, of course, got the slippers and things like that, an ironing board, big shoehorn, and, of course, nicely done here, there is the fabric freshener, so you can freshen up your fabrics. Final thing I want to show you that I forgot to mention when I was going earlier was in these drawers, sometimes this might belong in the closet, but they've got Marriott branded pajamas. Pretty fancy. Most Japanese hotels give you pajamas, so it's nice to see the Marriott doing that too. Okay, Topher, do you know what time it is? It's hotel review time. For those of you who watch our reviews regularly, you'll know we rate hotels on a scale of 1 to 5 Tophers. This hotel is going to get 4.5 tovers. So let's talk about the pros and then the cons of this hotel. We'll start with the pros and then go to the cons. I'm going to move this camera a little bit because we're going to talk about the first pro, which is the view. I mean, the view out of this hotel, it is truly amazing. Looking out on all of Osaka, it was a pleasure to wake up every morning and it was a pleasure to come back at night. I mean, Topher and I, we could just sit and stare out this window almost all day. And as I alluded to earlier, yes, you can see Osaka Castle from here. And what's also cool is if you go to Osaka Castle, then you can see this building from there. It's also neat that they give you a ticket to the Haruka's 300 Observatory, which is the observatory at the top of the building. So you don't just get to see the room from your view, but you get to see the view all around the building. The location right above the Tennoji subway station, while it's not central Osaka, this is quickly becoming Osaka's third downtown. It's very well connected. It's on the Midosuji subway line, which is the main subway line that runs through Osaka, so you can get to pretty much all of the tourist attractions really without having to transfer. The only one that's kind of not on that is Osaka Castle, but you can take the JR line with no transfers. If you're going to Universal Studios and Aquarium, those are the farther away. I think you do have to transfer to those, but it's a really convenient location, so I did like that. I also loved all the shops that are around it. Also being directly connected to the train station was nice, meaning you don't have to go outside in the weather, don't have to get wet or any of those things. If it's raining, you can just stay dry through the underground. The room, super nice, super quiet. Air conditioning worked well. I really enjoyed the bath. I enjoyed the bathtub because it just has a button that you push to start the water. 10 minutes later, the tub is full. So you almost have no reason to not take a bath. I found myself taking more baths than usual. So good Japanese bathroom. The water pressure was really good out of the shower. I love the fancy toilet. I love all the amenities in the room. I love that they have ice. Also, the staff here is excellent, super friendly, super helpful. Anytime I asked for directions, I got quick directions. You know, they bring your luggage to your room and they don't act like they're standing there waiting for a tip. And then the final pro is the lounge. The lounge is one of the best Marriott lounges that I have been to, if not the best. Certainly for the physical space that it's in, the space, it is very nice. It has these trees that are inside. It's a big two-story open space. When you come in, they basically seat you at a table. They ask if you want cappuccino or tea. They'll bring that to you. They have cook-to-order omelets. And it's not just a Western breakfast, but they have Japanese food as well. And so I really enjoyed the lounge. And then they've got the evening hors d'oeuvres and all those sorts of things. So the lounge was really nice if you're a Gold or Marriott Platinum member. All right, so let's talk about the cons. What's the cons about this hotel? Well, the room is nice, and it's a nice Marriott room. It's not overly spectacular, and I'm going to compare this to the Andaz in Tokyo. That's a room that you walk into and you're just like, oh my gosh, this room is amazing. But this room, it's nice. You look out at the view. The Andaz in Tokyo, it's another tower type room that has a great view, but they did a really good job on the rooms. I think that's my only quibble with this hotel. The only second quibble is then, you know, the fact that you kind of have to like take two elevators to go up and down makes it a little inconvenient to go down to like the convenience store or something like that, because it's not super quick to just go down, grab something from Lawson Station, come back up, because you've got to transfer through two elevators. But those are my only two quibbles, and so those are pretty small quibbles, but that's why it got a 4.5 toper. So if you are considering coming to Osaka, you should definitely consider the Osaka Marriott Miyako Hotel. Because I'll say, I usually avoid Western hotel chains in Japan, because I find them not to be a good value, and I find them often to be a little bit and a little bit run down. But this one, not run down, maintained very well, and they're meeting the high standards that I would expect of a typical Japanese hotel as well. So if you enjoyed this video and this was your first time here, please click on this yellow ball to subscribe, not to miss any of our new fun, informative travel videos, or you might enjoy watching some of our other videos from Osaka, Japan, and beyond. All right, thanks. Bye-bye.